I just wanted to share this quick tip on how you can do a little bit of formatting to your back-to-back charts in Excel. So we know back-to-back charts are not default charts. They're unique charts that we have to make from other default chart settings. So we're making these back-to-back charts from a 100% stacked bar chart. You can see my data source over here. We have two dummy columns on either side of my pre and post data. And you can see right here, if I click in the chart, you see that we've filled those dummy series with just no fill and no line. So it's kind of a ghost series behind the scenes there. But one thing that I really wanted to do is I wanted to fill more of this plot area with the actual dumbbells, because this is a 100% stacked chart. If you look at the horizontal axis, the x-axis, it's set from minimum of 0 and maximum of 100. Because it's a 100% stacked bar chart, everything is proportional anyway, so we can update those minimum and maximum values to fill more of the area with the chart. So let's go ahead and do that. Open the format axis pane. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna say, let's see, the minimum, let's set the minimum value to about 20% and the maximum to about 90% here. So I'm in the minimum, I'm gonna put 0.2, and in the maximum, we will put 0.9. And when I do that, you can see that it updates nicely and fills more of that plot area with the chart, and that's what I want to see. Now, the other thing, I have this y-axis over here, this vertical axis, and a lot of people like to put a line between the back-to-back to kind of create that diverging or cut point. So we can actually draw a line there. If we wanted to just insert a shape or a line, we could do that, but we can also embed it in the chart and make it part of the chart. So to do that, what we have to do is essentially move the axis line into the middle and then adjust the position of the labels here. So to do that, we're going to click on that x-axis again, the horizontal axis. When the format axis pane open, you can see that we have this option here that says vertical axis crosses at. Right now it's set to automatic, but I'm going to go ahead and click axis value, and I'm going to update that to 0.5, 50%, and then that axis line goes right into the middle. But the labels also go along with it because they are set to be next to the axis. We want to adjust the position of that. So go ahead and click on those labels there, and with the format axis pane open, go down to the little label caret right here, the label drop-down menu, and then right here it says label position. Right now it's set to next to axis, we're going to drop down and we're going to say low. And that's going to put it on the left side, the lower side of the axis. And so once we're done with this, we can just turn our x-axis white. We don't need that. Or we could just delete it altogether and you have a really nice back-to-back bar. Now the last thing we'll do is probably just move my custom legend labels right here, pre and post. Those are just text boxes that I put on top of the chart. So there's a quick little tip on how to format your back-to-back charts when you're making them from scratch. Thank you.